What's up guys, take the new video. In view today I'd like to talk a little bit about the Tronsmart Bang SE Party or something like that. So this is the like the smaller brother of the Bang Mini. So in the other video we'll also do like comparison with the Bang Mini and also the Mifa Wild Box for example. But this is just like a first impression video. So with the unpacking, it's very similar to the other Tronsmart speakers. Decent packed, especially very secure, so no damage on the speaker wall whatsoever. The overall design of this one is a little bit different than the other Bangs of Tronsmart. For example, you have this like carrying thing, and it's also a different build approach. It's the cheapest one of the three now. Like the Bang is now around, I believe, 110, 120 euros. The Bang Mini sometimes is even a little bit expensive than the Bang. This also has to do that like the Bang Mini was a big actually upgrade above the Bang. But Tronsmart is working on a new Bang version, so they just will call it the same, but it will have an improvement on Bluetooth, audio, battery and so on. So I'm curious to see how that one will perform. If it's ready, they will send it out and then we can do like a triple comparison. So this one is the cheapest now for around 70-80 euros. This does mean that the overall build quality is maybe a tight little bit lower than the other Tronsmart. But it's still okay. Like the Bang speakers are mainly for audio and like bigger, louder sound. The loudness on the speaker surprised me. It's pretty loud. It even has a little bit of a deep bass, but it's mostly a kicking bass, so a little bit in the upper side. The treble is there, but because it's full range drivers, you do have some limitations in the higher treble. And on like higher volume, you do get a little bit of a treble boost that's like on the edge of distortion. It's not distorting too much, but on max volume with even some like deep bass sound, it can be a little bit of a challenge for the speaker. All the samples that I will now be showing you guys will be with the Soundpools EQ, because without this EQ, it's also on default on the Soundpools. It's a little bit more muffled, it's a little bit more like flattened down a lot, and really not very dynamic. And don't get me wrong, normally I'm very fan of like very flat profile, but this one, it's just a little bit too much like pushed down. So with the Soundpools EQ, you have a lot of dynamics, the bass is also kicking pretty well. But as I mentioned before, the bass isn't like very deep. Then you really have to go back to the Tronsmart Bang. And like the Bang Mini is a little bit in the middle, so it has a little bit of a deep bass, but also like a focus on the upper bass. This one is really upper bass, kicking bass, as you will see now in the sample. We'll be right back. Samples, I can still say it's a very good approach of Tronesmart. And is this the best speaker for the price of around 70-80 euros? I'm not sure. But the problem is just with that price range, you have a lot of different kind of speakers. For example, I'm going to pick a few out of my closet. So for that price range, you can like, let's see. Okay, I have a few that are around that price range. For example, the Sound Dynamic, the other Sound Dynamic, the Vibe, so this small one, and of course the Mifa Wild Rod, still one of my favorites, like compact portable speakers. So the Sound Vibe speakers, these two are around 60 euros or $60. The Mifa is very close to the Tronesmart. So you must be thinking, the Tronesmart is a lot bigger, so bigger, better. It's not necessarily the size that matters always. I do sometimes say that like very tiny speakers will not sound great. This is like makes sense. But with the Mifa Wild Rod, they did do a very good tuning, especially with the latest update. So the previous update did had some like issues with some kind of music. With the latest update, some others even agree, it has been tuned very well now. The bass response is very surprising for this size. And I do can say that the deepness in the bass is a little bit better on the Mifa. But the Tronesmart, I will have to say it, it does go louder. It does have a little bit of a more body sound. And of course, this carrying around will make it a little bit more practical for like small parties and so on. But if you really want like a small speaker, very portable speaker, but still has like a very nice powerful sound, I do think that the Wild Rod is still a very good deal overall. So this just makes a little bit of an image about what you can get in this price range. And don't get me wrong, the Sound Dynamic speakers are great. They really are not the bad ones. I have seen some other brands that didn't perform very well, like the AY and also another brand I had in the past. It's just some brands just don't get there. And Tronesmart, Mifa, Sound Dynamic are getting very close to brands like JBL and Philips and LG and so on. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and see you guys around.